It was an assassination attempt on the scale of the Brighton bombing. It failed by only a matter of yards. ITN's cameras were in Downing Street at the time. The mortar bomb landed in the garden, shattering windows at the rear, just as the Prime Minister, John Major, and his war cabinet were discussing developments in the Gulf. Two other mortar bombs landed nearby but failed to go off. The van from which they'd been fired exploded in flames.
And just ahead of me was this van. It was burning quite ferociously, obviously been blown up or something. And at the minute, the police come up to me and turned me away and wouldn't let anybody else back down.
I see the roof, the actual top of the roof of the van's been ripped open. An angle, like a can of beans, basically. The top roof's at an angle, lifted up, as if something has come out of it, but it's hard to say, really.
Whitehall was sealed off, government buildings were evacuated, while bomb squad officers were brought in to deal with the two unexploded bombs.
The mortars appear to have landed on Foreign Office Green, and there may be a third on the lawn at number 10. There is certainly a lot of damage to the rear of the property, broken windows.
At the rear of number 10?
At the rear of number 10, yes.
As the hunt for the terrorists continues, the question remains, how were they allowed to penetrate security and launch an attack in the heart of government?